Good morning. So today, I need to look at my to-do list. Place orders. Fix string of time to use local. Yeah. So I think I need to fix that. That's going to be an interesting one. Not sure how we're going to do that. Don't know whether that's going to mean supplying a PR or whether it can actually, can it actually be done? Is there some sort of thing in it that allows me to change the format? So let's have a look. Let's go clone it. We'll have a look at the package first. Okay. What license is it? MIT. That's good. Okay, so what's it got going for it? I can... And extensions, custom specifications, okay. So new specification, set L to something other. Plus this new specification set to the string of time instance. Specification set. Okay, so it's kind of got a built-in override method whereby you can set your own formats. That might be the way that I can switch this, like %x doing American style, and instead say, okay, for this run, users in a UK locale, and so it needs to do day, month, year instead of month, day, year. Append interface. Okay, so the only thing I've then got to do is find locale stuff, which is a little bit, that's another thing to look at, isn't it? Okay, so in theory, I can do this kind of thing. And then I need to create a So how do I implement that then? Let's have an example. No. took the tests. So that's all plain formats. Blanks, zero pad. All right, this is the millisecond stuff. Yeah, but that's kind of built in, isn't it? Okay. All right. Specification set. And that's milliseconds again. All right, this is new. So I want percent X, that's the capital X, to print out my, okay. So there's some sort of verbatim function. So you could say, right, percent X. Now that's different to the example, which had percent, didn't have percents in it. Okay. So I'll have to be careful of that. Oh, okay, with specification, right. So specification A, so... All right, so that's the appender. So that's something that takes... Interesting. And then this one. Starts the same. Create a brand new specification. Set X to that appender. Not sure what that new stuff is about then. Oh, okay. So this is like a pre-compile, I bet. So this is basically doing a pre-format with that specification, and then you just run it. Another text, funny time. Okay. All right. Early morning text from various things. Right. Yeah, I don't know what to do here. I don't know whether that's... I'm going to have a look to see whether there's something other than verbatim. verbatim because I can't just use a string. So I would need to do something with a date and whatnot. Appenders. Okay. So standard lib format. Returns an appender that simply goes through time format. For example, if you know you want to display an abbreviated month name for P, you can create standard format with a pattern Jan and register that for specification P. Okay. So I could potentially use that then. Where's X? Yeah, that repo date, I bet that's the one. I'll have to check, but so it's using standard lib format. 010206, so that's month, day, year. I need to call it with a different setup there. So I'd go 02/01/06. Okay. Not quite sure how I'm going to do it, but I'm going to give that a go rather than trying to shoehorn locales into this library. It would be nice if I could just use it as is, because it seems to have this extension ability, and that might work. Because they've got verbatim here where they're just saying, okay. So where's all these things coming from? Nat repro date. Specifications. All right, okay. There we go. All right. So that's how it's getting to it. So it creates on init. Get a default specification set, which is a new mutable, new specification, blah, 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 specification set, Start. Okay, so it's a bit. Default populate specification. Okay. All right, so whipping through that list and adding them all to the specification set. And that's the. That's the formatter as such, and that's so, yeah, and that's the appender. So that's how you append the value for that date. Pass in, okay. All right, so this is going to be different, but we'll have a go. So it looks like I can do the standard lib format instead of, so where's the, yeah. I think it's probably best to take it from this test and basically create this new appender, but with standard lib format. And then I guess override with a set. So it's using new there. You might be able to just do this. Okay, let's try it. So first of all, where are we? Let's go here. Let's make sure everything's clean here. I've got anything out. So it's, I didn't do any changes elsewhere. I'll just make sure. So fine, there's nothing to do. Let's do a make clean. Do a make. Make a test. Everything looks good. Okay, we're in a good place there. Let's try adding a new thingy, a new state format. Okay, so we want to be an expand date. See what happens here. So at some point, so we've got a date format. Set up the date and then we call string f time format. So before then, we need to do something to set up string f time. I've got two of them, gotta be careful here. So that this percent x does something different. Let's make a break-in test. Okay, in the date. Oh, here's my to-do. Okay. I should probably do this as a separate test. So, we'll do. Take this. Take all that. Localized date format. So here we're going to, we know that we want to basically do a percent x, which is the default for this, which we've just checked by doing the above there. But now we're going to do a check to make sure it's as expected, which in my case should be percent d percent m percent lowercase y. So that will fail now. I'll turn that to do off there. We've now got a big to do here. So that should fail. So we expected the 1st of March 22, and we got back March 1st 22, UK versus USA version. So now we need to do something to set up string of time to deal with that in expand body. Okay. Not sure how we're going to do this. We need to kind of spike it, and see what we can get. So think, as per the tests, Where's ref coming from? Okay. So it's just UTC date. This kind of changes things up, doesn't it? What am I using? Look at that version of the format in the appenders. So I'm presuming that's where it's coming from. I know it's probably coming from the specification, isn't it? It's all different appenders. I probably should have checked this out. It would have been easier to look in, follow it through in Goland. Okay. There's no format there either. Okay, so that's specification set. Specification set. Like default specification and then set. Okay. Okay, I'm going to do this on the fly, I think. I'm going to use that. Let's do it on the fly, and we'll just swap this string f time here for a new specification set type thing. Okay, so we're just going to do it here. And then we'll move it to somewhere more usable later. Okay, so let's say let's call it a string string f time spec is going to be a string f time new specification set. And then it's going to be a string f time spec. No, that's not right. Look at the test again. Yeah, got to set it, that's right. Yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to break the other tests here. So I'm going to do dmy date is equal to string of time, standard lib format, and then it's which month is it that I'm supposed to do? Is that right? I can't remember. I can't remember the date for. O two is the day. Okay. So it's January 2nd, 06. Okay. And then as per the test, I need to set that. Don't think I need to do all this generally, but I'm going to do it here in my little test, because I think I wish P was named better here in this example, so I knew what it actually meant. Because I don't know, because there's different forms of new. How can we have... new in that form? I think it's okay. I think it's why. Yeah, I'm not sure that it's as complicated as I'm thinking it is. It's not. Okay, so we have string of time spec. And then we're going to create a string of time. All matter. Why not? Or potentially an error, apparently, which is string of time new. All right, so it's got a bit, okay. And we're passing in. And X is string of time. With specification spec, and I haven't done the set, so I need to do string of time spec. Set X to the string F. No. Yeah, to the day, month, year, date. Appender. Now it doesn't like that. No. I just do this then. Still doesn't like it. Why? What is that different to? Oh, it's a byte. Single byte. Okay. And then why is that complaining now? Oh. Well, that didn't do one, did it? Hmm. What does it return then? An error. Well, we're just going to throw it away. For the moment. Actually, no, it won't. Add any other errors. What did I do? I just returned this, the current string, didn't I? Substring. So it does nothing. And we'll do the same here. And then down here, yeah, why did you do that? This is what I don't get. Why? Where's this coming from? I don't want that. Right, I'm going to check it out so that I can properly inspect the code. That's frustrating. Okay, so in the specifications, See, that might be the way to go, actually. Right, okay. But I don't want to do that. Oh, okay. I can just pass the specification as one of the options to this. Okay. So I can extend format with. The option set. So. Let's look at format in here and see if that's used at all. So I've got a good option. Right, so that's time. Right, so it's not in the tests, unfortunately. That's a shame. So I can't see the exact way of doing it. But I could, I reckon. Alexons, I could probably do it on the fly, but I'm gonna carry on with. Just a specification set for the moment. But this might be really useful to say, okay. In this case, we know that the user has locale UK and should use this different format for the X. Okay, so what I'm going to do, so here, that should be back to that. And then we've got. Well, That's the bit that we need. We don't need that at all. Just need this new spec. So I'll just take that. I'm going to comment out that. And then here we append the new spec as an option, and then same down here. Okay. It might be as simple as that. So what I've done is I've said when X is used, I want it to use this other formatter, which is day, month, year. And I've set that on that spec. And then as an option to format, I'm saying use this different spec, which includes this new formatter for X. So I reckon I could do that on the fly at some point. Right, let's see how that goes. Let's do make test again. Okay. Is that right? Okay. We're getting an error now earlier on, which is good. Because that means it's working. So we're getting back. Yeah, we're getting back the 1st of March 2022, but we were expecting at the beginning, because we didn't have a different formatter, March 1st 2022, because that's on 48, which is the original, which uses that. Okay, that's good. So if I just comment out these for the moment, which makes all this go, well, actually, let's just double check by just move this one up. So it's just doing double the work, but this saves me mucking about. So this is me just making sure that my hypothesis is correct. Passes. Okay. So what we need to do now is have some way of switching between default and localized. So what we can do so I reckon let's do this. Um, Let's do something really sneaky. Let's find out what my lang is. Okay. ENGB. I wonder if I should have a setting for date format. Should really default to what's useful though. Let's look for a package that does locale stuff. I'm pretty sure I've looked before. Just need something that gives me a list of things. Okay, that's the one I remember. How do I get the locale in the first place? That's what I want to know. If I've got. No. 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 So there's nothing in my environment. PZ select. Just run that then. What do I get? No, that's not what I want, you see. I want it just to tell me what I've already got. I thought it would, because it said the other one. Use TZ select. I want abbreviation, I want long form time zone. I don't think I'm going to get it here. But that's not the same as the locale, so. Oh yeah, no, I was on. I need that. That's what I need. Don't know how to kind of dynamically load that. That's the problem. Got all these locales. How am I supposed to pick one? Maybe someone's asked. Using runtime locale. No. Okay. So yeah. How does that work? Have you got any examples? Get translator. Okay. Interesting. Okay. That could be useful. That'd be nice as a. But does it. What does it pull in for? Pulling in its own locales. Why is it forked? Thing is, I'm gonna have other things to like localize and translate as well, so should I use this instead? Run out of time as well before I'm gonna start doing this stuff. Universal translator. Okay, that's interesting, being able to pass in multiple. That's interesting. If I use that, I could use a fallback. I have to think about that because that's quite a change. Pulling in all that information and then setting things up. Be able to do the strings and date formats and so on. That's for no files. little bit more than I need at the moment. But I don't know whether I will need it by the time I get to translating strings and things. And it's still the case that I need to find a way of doing that, finding the user's locale but on the desktop. So I'm still going to have to do something like this kind of thing, looking at lang or something like that in the environment. If I what else is going to have ENGB? There's a few there. LC time. I could use LC time, and if that's not set, then fall back to lang. And then pick out the first part. Because it's the format we need, not the location. And that should be fine. But then I need to load it. And that means probably probably going for this one. Because it's certainly easier to use. Just using get translator. And then call in, well in this case hasn't got an example here, but the short date with a date of this. Because that's the standard date that's used for formatting. And then I can pass that to my string f time. Okay. Let's grab that, stick that in a to-do, because I've got to go. To-do. Get. Get date format. Okay, right, I've got to go, got to stand up. So, thanks for watching my little rambling investigation of locales and stuff. Still not sure what I'm going to do, but maybe I'll sleep on it and see. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care. Bye.